बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहु। वेलकम टू श्री चंद्राज डिस्टेंस लर्निंग प्रोग्राम। डियर इंटरमीडिएट सेकेंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर डीलिंग विद द टॉपिक दुरूसुन मिनल कुरानिल करीम। दिस इज़ योर फर्स्ट लेसन फ्रॉम सेक्शन प्रोस। ओके, दुरूसुन मिनल कुरानिल करीम। इन दिस लेसन यू हैव फोर सूरास, सूरतुल कुरैश, सूरतुल माउन, सूरतुल फलक एंड सूरतुल नास। दीज फोर सूरास यू हैव। सो फार वी हैव स्टडीड ऑल दीज फोर सूरास। ओके, सो फार वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सूरास। हाउ मेनी सूरास वी हैव स्टडीड सो फार? वी हैव स्टडीज फोर सूरास, ऑल द फोर सूरास इन अवर क्लास, इन अवर क्लासेस, अर्लियर क्लासेस। वॉट वॉज द सूरास? सूरास आर सूरतुल कुरैश, ओके, सूरतुल कुरैश, सूरतुल माउन एंड सूरतुल फलक, सूरतुल नास। दीज फोर सूरास वी हैव स्टडी। नाउ वी विल प्रोसीड टूवर्ड्स द एक्सरसाइजेस। ओके, इन द एक्सरसाइज सेक्शन, in the first exercise he has given the word meanings. Okay, word meanings, we need not to solve the word meanings because that may not, that will not come in your exam. The second exercise is singular to plural. This is also not necessary, we are leaving it. Exercise number 3 is adad, al azdad, opposites. This is also we are leaving because this will not come in your final exam. So we are starting with the exercise number 4. Uktubil khulasa, uktub khulasata suratul quraish, write the summary of surah al quraish. Okay, he is asking you to write the summary of surah al quraish. So what you have to do, you have to give the summary. In what manner you have to give the summary? First you have to translate all the verses of the surah. If possible write the surah. If not, at least write the translation of the surah, then write the summary which I have sent to you in your notes. Okay, first you have to write translation of verses. Give the heading summary of surah al quraish. Okay, give the heading summary of surah al quraish. Then you have to take translation of ayats. Okay, first verse is لِئِلَا فِي قُرَيْش, to awake drive amongst the Quraysh. Okay, to awake drive amongst the Quraysh, لِئِلَا فِي قُرَيْش. Second ayat is لِئِلَا فِي قُرَيْش, إِلَا فِيهِمْ رِحْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ. You have to write the translation إِلَا فِيهِمْ, to acclimatize, to get familiar, to acclimatize the Quraysh tribe with the commercial trips in the winter and summer season. Okay. Next is verse number 3. Rihlat al-shitai was saying, فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. They should worship the Lord of this sacred house. They should worship the Lord of this house. Next, what is that? Verse number 4. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. He has fed them against hunger. He has provided sustenance in extravagant conditions. And he has given food in hunger. And he has given security and peace at the time of fear. Okay, write the translation. Ilafim rihlat ash-shitai wasaf falyabudu rabb hadha al-bayt alladhi at'amahum min ju'in wa amanahum min khawf. He has provided the food against hunger and has given security in fear. Okay, this is the translation. Let's take a review of the surah. here, and now you have to write in the summary, this surah belongs to Makkah. Means this surah was revealed in Makkah. It has 4 verses and 1 section. Its position in the Quran is 106. Okay. This surah is connected with the previous surah, that is Surah Al-Fil. In Surah Al-Fil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded a great favor done by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the people of Quraysh. That is destroying and killing the people of elephant and their king. Destroying the king Abraha and their army. This favor has been done by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the sake of Quraysh. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding them to think about it, that Allah has bestowed boons on you. Allah has favored you by destroying the king. In the pagan times, in pre-Islamic times, the people, the clan, the tribe, Quraysh people used to go for business trips without any fear and restriction to Yemen and Sham, to Yemen and Syria, without the fear of fools, robbers and decades. Without the fear, they used to travel. Okay. They used to travel to Yemen in winter season because it was a hot country, and they used to travel to Syria in summer season because it was a cold country. The decades and robbers and fools do not dare to loot the caravans of Quraysh. They do not attack on the Quraysh caravans. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put fear in them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has destroyed the Abraha and his army for the sake of Quraysh, and they give respect to the people of Quraysh because they are the servers, they are the servants of, they are the servants, they are serving the house of Allah. They serve the people who go there for pilgrimage. Okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put fear in their hearts, so they leave the caravans of Quraysh. So in return, at least they have to remember this favor that Allah has provided them sustenance, by way that Allah provided business in other countries. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put love for business in the people of Quraysh to do business, because cultivation cannot be done in the land of Makkah because that is a dry land. All the rocks are there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put love for the business in the hearts of the people, in the hearts of the people of Quraysh. So they started traveling, they started paying commercial trips to Yemen and Syria. Okay. Without the fear of decades, without the fear of robbers, without the fear of fools, without any fear, they used to travel here and there. If a person used to say, I belong to the Quraysh tribe, then the decades used to leave him. Why? Because they are the servers, they are paying the service to the house of Allah. They are serving the house of Allah, they are serving the pilgrimage, they are the serving pilgrimage. Okay. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding them this favor and asking them to in return worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of this house. ड्यू टू दिस सर्विस यू आर एक्नॉलेजिंग यू आर फेसिंग इजीनेस इन द ट्रू एंड फॉल्स इन द विजिट्स सो यू हैव टू पे यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस फेवर एंड शुड हैव वर्शिप शुड वर्शिप द लॉर्ड ऑफ दिस सेक्रेट हाउस अल्लाह सुबहानहु व तआला बाद एंड एज अ साइन ऑफ थैंक्स गिविंग एज अ साइन ऑफ थैंक्स गिविंग यू शुड वर्शिप द लॉर्ड ऑफ दिस हाउस इन दिस वे यू कैन राइट द समरी व्हाट इज द सेकेंड एक्सरसाइज द सेकेंड एक्सरसाइज इज ही इज आस्किंग यू टू राइट द समरी ऑफ सूरह अल माउन सूरह अल माउन यू हैव स्टडीज लेट्स टेक अ रिव्यू माउन मीन्स One more point we missed in the Surah Al-Quraysh. Surah Quraysh take its name from the first verse, Al-Quraysh. Li'ila fi Quraysh. In the first verse, the word Quraysh is mentioned. From there, the word is taken for naming the Surah. In Surah Al-Ma'un, Ma'un means, literally it means utensils, but it has a broader meaning. It means household objects, household objects, household things, daily use objects. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in this surah, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Araital ladhi yukadhibu biddin. Have you seen the one who denies the day of resurrection? Fadhalika ladhi yadul yateem. He is the one who repulses the orphan. Wala yahuddu ala ta'amil miskin and did not encourage the cause of feeding poor people. Fawailul lil musallin, so woe to those worshippers. Alladhi hum an salatihim sa'un, who are unaware of the spirit of the prayer, who are negligent of the prayers. Alladhi nahum yuraun, they do charity only to show off. وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَعُونَ and behold and refuse to lend the small objects of daily use even on demand. Okay, this is the translation. Now the summary is, this surah taken its name from the last verse وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَعُونَ and it has other names also like the religion, the orphan and it contains 7 verses. It was revealed in Makkah. In this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the bad habits of infidels, disbelievers. He has mentioned they do not believe in the day of resurrection. And instead they deny the day of the resurrection, day of judgment. This is a bad habit of the infidels of Makkah. Secondly, they do not mercy on orphans, and they take their wealth unjustly. They take their orphans' wealth unjustly. And do not encourage the cause of feeding the poor, beggars and needies, and they prevent others from doing this act. Fourthly, they do not offer the prayer with etiquettes, with its all etiquettes and its conditions. They used to leave the prayer in the conscience. Physically they are present, but spiritually they are absent in the prayer. Laysa lahum riayatun li awqati salati, they don't care for the times of the prayer. Lastly, wa yamnauna min atai al-ashiya' al-adiya, they refuse to lend the household objects of daily use like water and tub, pot, salt, fire, thread, and needle, etc. from this surah we get the following results. The result is, it is obligatory on every Muslim to believe in the day of judgment and do justice with the orphans. Whoever denies the day of judgment, he is deviating from the Islam. Secondly, alaina an narhama al yatama wal masakin, we are supposed to show mercy towards the orphans and needies and poor people. Thalithuha itamu ta'am, we must strive to promote the cause of feeding. This is a good habit which is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fourthly, it is obligatory on every Muslim to establish the prayer, five times prayer, with all its etiquettes and conditions. And take care of the timings of the prayer. Because Allah, the Prophet of Allah said, As-salatu imaduddin, namaz, prayer, namaz is the pillar of religion. Faman akhamaha akhamaddin, whosoever establish it, he is as if he is establishing the religion. And waman tarakaha, whosoever leaves it, as if he is destroying the religion. Vamantaraka hadamaddin. Lastly, exchanging of the daily objects is refused by some people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is prohibiting from this bad habit. We must share our daily use objects with our neighbors and friends. Okay. Now the next exercise is reference. What is the section reference? We will do this on the board. Next exercise, we have solved the exercise number 1, Suratul Quraysh. Second exercise, Suratul Maun summary. Two exercises over. Now third exercise, reference, give reference. Okay. Min ayyati suratin, min ayyi suratin hazihil ayah. Okay. Give reference. He will ask you to give reference. Okay. What he will do? He will give you the verses of the Quran. Verses of the Quran. And ask you to give the reference of the particular ayat. For example, here it is given, فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. We need not to translate it, just we have to give the reference to which surah this verse, this ayat belong. Give reference in Arabic. This reference we have to give in Arabic. Min ayyi suratin hazihil ayat. To which surah these ayats are belong. Here, فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. Which surah it belongs, فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. This verse belongs to the surah Al-Quraysh. So how we will write answer? We will write the answer as, هَذِهِلْ آيَتُ. Hadhi laya, so this verse, हादी लायतु हादी लायतु ओखिजत, और डायरेक्टली वी कैन राइट हादी लायतु मिन सूरतिल सूरतिल कुरैश। हाजिल आयतु मिन सूरतिल कुरैश, दिस इज द वन वे ऑफ आंसरिंग। एंड अदर इज दिस मीन्स दिस आयत बिलोंग्स टू द सूरा अल कुरैश। ओके, दिस आयत बिलोंग्स टू द सूरा अल कुरैश। हादिल आयतु मिन सूरतिल कुरैश। वन आंसर इज दिस, अदर इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन राइट द सेम आंसर इन अदर वर्ड्स एज वेल। आई विल डू दिस इन द सेकेंड वर्ड्स ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज। वॉट इज द सेकेंड वर्ड? सेकेंड वर्ड्स इज कुल औदु बि रब्बिन नास। सेकेंड वर्ड्स इज कुल औदु बि रब्बिन नास। कुल औदु बि रब्बिन नास। नाउ वी हैव टू आंसर दिस वर्ड्स। वॉट ही इज आस्किंग? ही इज आस्किंग यू टू गिव रिफरेंस इन अरबिक। हाउ वी विल गिव द रिफरेंस? वी हैव टू एंड वी हैव टू रिकग्नाइज आइडेंटिफाई दैट टू विच सूरा दिस वर्ड्स बिलोंग्स। कुल औदु बि रब्बिन नास, हियर नास इज मेंशनड, सो दिस बिलोंग्स टू द सूरा अन्नास। हाउ वी कुड राइट हाजिही आयतु उखिजत, हाजिही आयतु उखिजत, दिस वर्स इज टेकन मीन फ्रॉम द मीन सूरा, दिस वर्स इज टेकन फ्रॉम द सूरा मीन सूरति अल नास। In the translation is this verse or ayat is taken from the surah An-Nas, the people. Got it? Take the snapshot.